A doctor employed by the company which assesses people for disability benefits has strongly criticised its methods as unfair. In an interview with the BBC, Greg Wood says he felt compelled to speak out after he saw what he claims was medical knowledge being twisted against people. The company, ATOS, denies the allegations, as our correspondent Sophie Hutchinson reports.
Emma Hackett suffers from chronic pain and mental health problems. In the past few years, she has twice been rejected for the full sickness benefit following a work capability assessment.
Not only do I feel bad that I can't work, other people are making me feel bad that I can't work.
Emma challenged her assessment and won. Since 2008, tribunals have overturned well over a third of assessment appeals in favour of claimants. The company ATOS carries out the assessments for the government, and both have been heavily criticised for causing misery at a huge cost to the taxpayer.
The job is, although it's...
Now, for the first time, a doctor who worked for ATOS has decided to speak out. Greg Wood, a former Royal Navy doctor, has resigned as an assessor because he was so sickened by the system.
Well, these assessments need to be done independently, impartially, considering all the evidence and with proper use of medical knowledge. And that's just not happening at the moment. Pressure is being put on healthcare professionals to, in many cases, come up with a particular outcome, really regardless of the facts of the case.
Dr. Wood alleges the assessments for the employment and support allowance are unfair and unethical. He claims he was instructed to change reports. He says that medical knowledge is twisted, and he says the system is skewed against the claimant.
One of the claims is that assessors are taught if a person can walk the short distance from their kitchen to their living room, it proves they can walk 200 metres and so be fit for work. And if a person is able to get dressed at some point during the day, it means they have enough motivation and concentration to hold down a job.
But this relentless pursuit.
ATOS strongly rejects the claims. In the company's first television interview about the assessments, it insisted it's providing a good service.
During the assessment, a number of questions are asked, and those questions are to complement the medical evidence and to build a picture of someone's lifestyle and complete capabilities. So there are numerous questions, and anyone taken out of context might seem somewhat odd.
But on rehab.
Dr. Wood also claims the system is failing some of the most vulnerable who are being asked to attend assessments. He saw many distressing examples.
Someone with motor neurone disease, which again, progressive neurological condition, who I actually put in the terminal illness group because he was, who should not have come for a face-to-face assessment.
What is so upsetting about meeting somebody?
Because it's cruel.
The government says it strives to ensure people with terminal illness do not have face-to-face assessments. It says it's getting 85% of decisions about the benefit right. Nevertheless, Emma lives with the anxiety that she will be reassessed and could lose the support she desperately needs. Sophie Hutchinson, BBC News.
The internet giant blated